想着就讲。
So whatever crossed his mind, he said it.
这个人常常真无可爱。
This kind of people, they are so unlovable.
有人看真未歹。
So some people, they look nice.
但是一开声就歹。
But the moment they open their mouth, they look awful.
讲的话都是真戆的话，都是真真批评性的话。
Because their words are stupid and they are hypocritical.
这个人无可爱。
These people are not likable.
这就是彼得。
That's Peter. But God, Jesus, loves him till the very end.
John, 写这个 Gospel of John 的 John, 本身自己说我是主所听的门徒。
So the author of this book of John, John the Apostle, said he's the beloved apostle of God, of
John,
Jesus.
John 本身无可爱。
John is also not very lovable as a person.
有另外一个名。
John has another name.
叫做雷子，叫做雷公Thunder。
His other name is the Son of Thunder. He's a very ill-tempered person. He looks so nice when he's calm, but the moment he erupted, he looks like a monster. If your husband is like that, do you think he's likable? So in normal circumstances, he would behave. But when in extreme circumstances, he would just erupt. That's John. So there was a time when Jesus passed by a place. The people very refused to accept Jesus.
John
and the John said,
主啊，你吩咐君，吩咐火对天顶降来烧先。
So John said, Lord, do you want us to call fire down from heaven to destroy them? That's John. So can you imagine both of us go on a visitation? And this person refused to open the door. So what is the other person? How about asking God to send fire from heaven and burn everybody inside? That's John. He's a very temperamental person. This person is very lovable. But God, Jesus, nevertheless loved him till the very end. The person who betrayed Jesus, Judas, for 3 years he followed Jesus. So all his provisions are from Jesus. And in the end, he betrayed Jesus. He is an ungrateful person. This person is completely unlovable. But nevertheless, Jesus loved him till the very end. How about the other disciples?
一拜、两拜、三拜讲，三字最多，三字最头啊。
So among the disciples, time and again, they have been arguing who is the greatest among them. They are not lovable. But Jesus loved them till the very end.
Submit.
Why is it so? Because Jesus said, because these disciples are mine. Why do parents love their children very much? Because they ascertain something for themselves. Children, they are mine. They are gifts from God. Even if he doesn't behave, I love this child till the very end. That's really truly so. There are really many instances of kids, they are very unlikable. And I usually say, if I were the dad, I'm going to spank the person. But let me tell you, if this child is truly my son, I wouldn't dare spank him. Because that is my son. So there's always something very ironic in the relationship between parents and children. On the one hand, they can be very furious. But on the other hand, they can be so soft-hearted. Because this is my son. There was a time when I visited a brother, a Christian brother in the U.S. He has three kids.
哎呀，真可惜，有一个囡仔是出生就有问题。
But there's a kid there that's physically has some physical problem. Was born with that. And he couldn't speak for a lifetime. He couldn't walk for a lifetime. He couldn't feed himself. He's just in that chair. Somebody has to take care of him for a lifetime. I actually feel very, very sorry for the parents. I wouldn't really know how to take care of this kind of a kid. But I can see the heart they pour into taking care of this kid.
kinh nghiệm được Chúa đối với chúng ta.
And then I have a glimpse of what God's love is to us.
Một cái chắc khi ông mục sư hỏi xin cái con ngồi kia.
So there was one morning when the brother said, "Pastor, can you please take care of my son for me?"
Okay, okay, và cơ trong buổi chàng bị cả đồ lại.
So I need to buy something, and I'll be back.
Ông mày học coi à?
And then I immediately said, "I don't think I know how to handle this."
Cái này là cẩn thận, anh qua được chơi là qua được chơi, anh mày học trâu là anh qua được chơi rồi.
And then he said, "No, big deal. It's just a matter of taking care of him and just look after him."
Coi như lần chỉ đấm hòa chân lần đấm chân.
Actually, I was taking care of this boy for 2 hours. I'm actually very, very frantic. And I was just imagining the kind of love that make the parents take care of this kid for a lifetime. Because this kid is mine. God loves still the very
end.
Because you are his.
但是,
however,
however,
unless we experience that love,
你不可能用这样的天来回应上帝,
you will never learn how to respond to this God.
上帝听你,
Jesus loves you.
听你告对,
and he loves you till the very
end.
May I ask,
你有感到上帝听你告对吗?
Do you feel that kind of an experience of God loving you till the very end?
保罗说一句话,
Paul said,
管来基督的听激烈过,
Paul said, the love of Christ compelled me.
上帝天 compel us, 好像我保罗说这个真正特别的工作来侍奉上帝。
So the great love of God compelled Paul to do a great ministry for God.
请问上帝天有激励到你的生命吗?
May I ask, has God's love compelled you in your life?
我这个男的感受了，但是真无乖。
There's this man who was married to this woman, but he's a very nice husband. He has many adulterous relationships outside. And we heard that he has other partners in outside. So eventually he parted ways with a wife. So the wife was begging him not to leave, but nevertheless he left. Nevertheless, he left. So he still parted with the wife. So he left the wife with a child, and then they parted ways. 10 years, he didn't come back. So for 10 years, he's been outside, he's been drifting, he has been enjoying his life. 10 years later, he was already exhausted. There's really no true love in this world. So he was already tired. So he wanted to go back. So when he went back, so when he knocked the door, so the wife opened the door. He was so remorseful when he saw the wife. That's for 10 years. So within this period of 10 years, he never took care of the wife and the son. So when he saw the wife, he was actually very remorseful. But he has no way to go now. So he told the wife, please accept me once again. Please accept me once again as your husband. So he began to cry. He never would have thought that the wife would respond to him this way. So the wife embraced him. So she told the husband, the moment you left this house, I still, every day, consider you as my husband. I'm just waiting for you to come back. This is your house. So for 10 years, he never bothered about the family, the wife, the son. So she kept telling the kid that the father is out of the country. And he will come back very soon. So when the husband heard the wife said that, he couldn't hold it. He knelt before the wife. So he cried and sobbed. But from that day on, so the wife got back a very good husband. This time the son has a good father. Because through the wife, the husband became a Christian eventually. And he made this open testimony in the church.